came to the president of the state, we were gonna have a Christmas party, and he said, everybody thinks that Joseph Fielding Smith and the brother are just having a ball like we are. They don't have a darn thing to do. My sister tells me we're just sitting around the home not doing anything. Why don't you invite him to our Christmas party? Well, you'd have to know Quail Ward, who was state president. He was a happy, go-lucky guy, big laugh. We had the party. Joseph Fielding Smith and his new wife came to the party. They played a duet at the piano. They sang together. She was a very deep voice contralto on the Tabernacle Choir. And he said, you know, nobody in the church likes Joseph Fielding Smith. Now this Joseph Fielding Smith talking. Because I always am the apostle that says, repent. Repent. Now the Grand Richards goes around and says, it's a church of love. But he said, I always have a feeling to tell them to repent. President McKay came to me and said, Joseph, you're going to speak in the afternoon session of Congress. So he said, I went to my office and I prepared a talk from Joseph Fielding Smith without the word repentance in it and tried to put love every place I'd said repentance. And he said, I wrote it, that, had that thing out, I had all ready to go. And when I got up to close the door to go out the door, I put my hand on the knob. And my father, that was Joseph
F.
Smith, the son of a brother.
Hiram.
What was the prophet's brother?
Hiram.
Said, my son, it will be your office and your calling to cry repentance to this people every day of your life. He said, I took my hand off the handle. He's standing there with tears running down his face. And I went back and put my famous address in my drawer. And I quietly closed the drawer. Went back, and the church got another repent ye Joseph Fielding Smith. This is a wonderful, great church. It is the life of life. And every one of us that are here today have been blessed to have someone lay hands on your head and give you the priest of God. And it's in your heart. You've had a baptism. Jesus Christ himself said, I will give you the Holy Ghost. So in addition to the offices that you have the speaking of the Holy Ghost to you, to guide you in direction. I bless you all. All I say is I'm with you all the way right here at this room. But for heaven's sake, get something that can talk as loud as I am. Edison built them. You've got new funnels in your pockets. Let's get a good couple of microphones in here so that I can hear those sweet, wonderful men over there. I love you.